Hey guys, what's going on? And welcome back to another Minecraft video. Today I am on the Westeros craft server. I am going to be starting a walkthrough series showing their builds, and I just think that it's a major inspiration to be able to walk through these and show you guys some of them, because for those of you that maybe don't want, or you know, don't want to take the effort to join the server, maybe you can watch these videos and see some details and some things that might help you on your builds. And the Westeros craft server, for those of you, since this is my first video, I'll just sort of give you a little introduction into the server. The Westeros craft is a basically a Minecraft server based on the Game of Thrones series, and they are recreating the world of Westeros, the continent of Westeros, and it is absolutely phenomenal. The map, I think, is 60,000 blocks tall and 30,000 blocks wide. It's a huge map, and the thing that really is attracts me, and I guess other builders, is that it's cohesive. That there's roads connecting everything. Everything has a purpose, and basically it's just towns and villages and hamlets, and it's all broken down into the vassal state sort of, you know, how, you know, the political system of the medieval ages would be, because, you know, there'd be lords, there'd be dukes, there'd be kings and such all throughout the land, and they are recreating the cities, the towns, the villages, pretty much everything you can think of as far as Game of Thrones is concerned. They are trying to recreate, and they are doing a spectacular job on recreating it. So, you know, this server definitely, I mean, it has a lot of popularity, a lot of people know about it, but, you know, the more people that push forward with it and popularize it, I'm sure would be beneficial for them, and I think that it would be great to do so. So anyways, as we're walking through Last Hearth, that is the name of this build. It is basically in the north. It is, I'm reading the wiki right now. I'm not going to pretend that I know much about all this, but basically the Last Hearth is the seat of House Umber. A vassal state, or vassal house, holding fealty to House Stark of Winterfell. It is located south of the Gift, east of the King's Road, and north of the Last River. So if you go north and you keep going north, it'll take you to Castle Black. If you go south a little bit, it'll take you down towards, if you go south a little bit and a little bit, I think east, or west, southwest, it'll take you to Winterfell. And if you go that way, you know, there's all kinds of different things, and they actually have Winterfell finished and everything. So there's a lot of like really popular locations that they have built so far on this. Right now they're working on King's Landing. I think they just finished Winterfell, and they you know, they got Storm's End done, they got Lannisport done. Basically this video series is going to take a long time to get through, because there is so much to see, so many things to do. So yeah, but what we're going to need to do, what we are going to be doing is pointing out details and things that you could put into your builds and such, and that will hopefully inspire you. So first of all, we're looking through a candle maker. Excuse me. We're looking through a candle maker, and they have a pretty good system in order to make candles here. Basically, you got a rope, and you got the candles hanging from the rope. You would drizzle the wax over the candles, and then that's how you would make the candle, basically, is just drizzling and stuff like that. I guess this is supposed to represent raw wax, as you can't really do much in concerns to that, because you know, you only have so many blocks. But as they are progressing, they are adding in more blocks. That's the cool thing about Westeros Craft, is they have their own custom launcher, so they can have all the blocks they want. And basically, if you want to have this launcher, I got you to just go to their website, which is in the description, and download their launcher and join the server. And there sometimes are complications depending on what your client is and everything, so you might have to troubleshoot a little bit here and there, but Eventually, you'll be able to get Han, hopefully, and check things out for yourself, because it's just incredible. But yeah, this here is actually a really cool idea. A little pavilion to be outside. You can imagine that the soldiers and maybe the, not soldiers, but just like the men of the village, after a hard day's work, they would just sort of congregate around places like this and talk about their days, stories and such. And that's actually a really cool idea. It adds a social life to your build. And just things like that really add in a great thing to your build. I mean, there's no way else to describe it other than it's just a beautiful way to add in a social system and such. So as we're going down this way, there's lots and lots of things to see. There's always things to see. There's, no matter where you are, you walk into a house or a building, just a structure in general, and there's always going to be something interesting to see. Because they really go all out into their interiors, they go all out into their builds in general, and they really try to put forth a immersive environment, because the eventual goal of the Westeros Craft server is to make it into a massive RPG server for Minecrafters, so that people can work their ways up to lords and knights, all these different types of titles, and that they can have their own villages and their own cities and everything to have, and it's just a really cool environment to be able to walk around in and explore. So here we got a stockade. The wall all the way around Last Hearth is a stockade. Obviously, I don't really know why. I mean, I guess it's a poorer town. They have, as you can see, the stockades go all the way around. They got some stone base here for the towers. Some of the towers have stone bases, but the majority of it is stockades. I guess because it's such a, basically a flourishing resource around this build, I guess they just decided that, hey, we got a bunch of trees, why don't we use them and make it into a stockade? Made it into a quick thing. And then they have the moat all the way around, as you can see here. Now, they don't have, like, they just use a bunch of pike little things. As you can see, they're trying to represent pikes and such, and they have some mud in there. Looks really nice. But yeah, the build on the outside looks really cool. They have it very bordered. That's a pretty cool thing. It's typically, us conquestors, we just like to build outside, and we always like to add details around. They have details around us too, but they try to border it around with a wall, and then they put everything that they need to build inside it. So, but anyway, this is the House of Umber right here. Umber. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Umber. I'm just going to call him Umber, because that's how I think that it's supposed to be called. But correct me if I am wrong. But yeah, Last Hearth is a beautiful build. As you can see, it's very Nordic, very northern. If you just go up the road a little bit, for example, this here is a road. This is the main road, I am presuming. Yeah, this is the main road right here. And if you go all the way up that road, it'll take you down to the other places throughout the map. And it looks like we got ourselves a sawmill here. Now, I explored this earlier, and as you can see, the saw does not look complete. I don't know what's going on there, but yeah, that's that. And still, it's pretty cool. You definitely have a sense of a trade that's going on here. Some sort of, he looks to be rather rich. Maybe it's owned by the the Duke himself, or the Lord that is over these lands. Maybe it's privately owned by some sort of richer trade or craftsman that owns this sawmill or something. But one way or the other, it looks pretty nice. They have a pretty cool thing going on. The carts would come up here with their logs, and then they would offload the logs onto here, I am presuming. Or no, they would, this is where they would do the logs, right here. And they would lift the logs up off the cart, then they would bring it into here. I don't know what this system is. Yeah, but anyway, it's pretty cool. I like it. Cool. I can see, but I'm not sure which way or the other. I'm pretty sure they would offload the logs here, bring it across, They would cut it into lumber, and then they would offload it into carts, which would take it away and possibly take it even into the city or into the town. This is not a city. Take it into the town where they would produce it into houses or firewood. No, not firewood. Houses, barns, sheds, even crates. Who knows? Doors. So we're in here. This is a stable, or maybe not a stable. This is probably, I'm going to presume, a cattle pen. Reason being is it just seems very open to be a stables. I'm going to assume that this is a cattle pen because it's sort of larger. Plus you have a butcher over here. So it would just make sense if whatever was over here was an animal. I mean, maybe they eat horses, but whatever is over here is just basically meat for the slaughter for over here. And this is where they would grab their hearty meat and slab it down and have it for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So we're going to go ahead and head up here a little bit, and we're going to go into the gate, which leads into the actual keep itself. Now, the cool thing is it is a tiered defense. So basically, in order to get into the keep, I mean, of course, you could just bust through the wall, but in order to get through from the town, you'd have to go through these gates, find your way up to the next level, which is up here, and go across, go through this gate, and then you'd have to go up this causeway and leads into the gate as well. There's also smaller little places to get in, like here's a big door here and some things in there, but we aren't going to really explore all of this. Now, the reason I'm not gonna explore all this, because obviously that would take forever. We would have probably a hour, 2 hour long video. Plus it would get rather boring. I'm just going to show you what highlights that I can find, and hopefully we can enjoy it one way or the other. So I am going to presume that we are in a kennels right now, because as you come out, you got some little open cages, open air cages here. And I just think that this is a kennels because it's a, you have a pen in here, and then you come out here. It just looks to me like it's kennels. Correct me if I am wrong. Plus, another thing that I really want to do is credit all the builders. So for those of you that are on Westeros Craft and are watching this video, I might do it on the future while I'll ask or something, but where is a place where I can ask? Like I guess I could on the server, but maybe I could on the forums, is ask who all the builders were that created these builds. So like as I go through and I do each video, because I think it's very important to credit the builders, you know, credit the server obviously, but the thing is the server is not the server without the builders, and I just want to make sure that the builders are credited and that they have proper recognition for what they have done, because people can sort of see what people can do, and that's a pretty cool thing. So anyways, let me go ahead and turn on CUDA shaders, because it is a much better interior shader thingamajigger. There we go. We got some light. So now we're gonna head down underneath the tree here. Honestly, I don't think I should come down here, but anyway, we're just going to explore just a little bit. Looks like we got a tomb down here. The ancient lords of Last Hearth would be put down here. As you can see, you got some quartz sort of burial sites. And I'm guessing if you come down here, yeah, this is the less noble burial sites. I'm pretty sure that not everyone is put down here. Like, not all of the people of Last Hearth, so I guess the rest are maybe cremated or buried elsewhere, I don't know. But I don't think that this crypt would be able to be big enough in order to bury all of the citizens of Last Hearth. So there has to be, like, these are probably burial sites for maybe, upper class people that can afford to reserve their tomb underneath the weirwood tree, which is actually really cool. I love this idea, beautiful idea. And another thing that I thought was a really cool idea is this greenhouse out here, where they were actually grow like lettuce and stuff. We will actually see that when we go inside. Really cool feature of this build, and it's something that's kind of unique. Not many people build greenhouses on their builds, mainly because it's not, I don't think it's really realistic, because I don't think they had greenhouses back in these days. But you know what, who cares? It's awesome. That's all that matters. But then again, correct me if I'm wrong. So this here is the Great Hall as you come in. And one thing that I really want to point out is the spiral walkway in order to enter into the main entrance. This is a really cool design, and it's very defensible in my opinion, because as soldiers or enemies are coming up, you can go ahead and close this gate, and this whole side would be blocked, and so the enemy would have to really kind of cause a lot of problems. Now, of course, they can walk through the pen, come around, and jump up, but it's much easier to try to... Actually, it's not much easier. Either way, it's going to be difficult, but one way or the other, you can have soldiers up here shooting arrows down, and it's just a really cool defensible feature that really works quite well. And we're going to go ahead and explore the keep a little bit. We can't explore it too much because we don't want to take up too much time, but as you can see, we got the throne room in here. You got the seats for the queen, maybe the prince or the princess, who knows. Whatever royalty lives in this keep, this fort. I'm going to say this is a fort because it looks like a fort to me. But anyway, we got some tables over here for the noblemen, the more nobles sitting at the front, and then the less nobles sitting at the back. So you can imagine maybe like upper craftsmen, the blacksmith, maybe the butcher, like people of notable, or like say if they're having guests, you know, the people that are very important would be sitting at the front of the tables, and then the people that are less important would sit at the back. Now, of course, this could also be a dining hall, but I imagine this is probably the place where, people would come in, tell the Lord their problems, and the Lord would, on his dais, pronounce, what he would do for them and how he would like to fix their problems or whatever. So, cool. So now we're in here. This is the actual kitchen of the Last Hearth. And we got a lot of storage. This is basically reflected on the other side, but then on the other side it's meat and vegetables and such. But as you can see, we got wine storage, lots of mead and barrels, sacks of flour. We got firewood over here for all the fireplaces, because obviously we're gonna need a lot of that. We got a bakery in here, and we're gonna head over this way. We got a place to heat up some water. That's something that's very important. Not many people think about that, but yes, you need places to heat up water. Place to smoke and heat up some meat. You got a little kitchen in here, and if you go this way, there's just a lot of meat storage. There's an ice room back there, and there's just a lot of things that you can see in here. And one of the cool things about Westeros Craft is they really try to go in depth with their interiors, especially with castles and forts and keeps and such. They try to put everything that they can into these builds to try to represent, a very, immersive environment that would actually work. So now we go down into here. This is the actual dungeons of the keep. There's only four cells in here. Obviously, the thing about dungeons, and especially in real life castles, at least from what I have read, is that dungeons were a rare thing, because why would you keep someone for a long period of time? Obviously that, is not cost effective, because then you gotta feed the prisoner and, and upkeep and such like that. It's just probably not worth it. So anyways, enough of that. So now it looks like we got ourselves a couple privies in here. I don't think we can go down into there, unfortunately, but we got four privies in here where they would do their deeds into the pits down below. I imagine they'd have to clean that out occasionally, which would be a rather stinky job in both the literal and metaphorical speaking. So now we're gonna go up here, and we got another little place where people can meet around the fire. And we're gonna, everything is pretty much rooms from this point on. I guess we could try to find our way up to the king's room. I don't think this castle, this keep or fort, whatever it is, has a rookery, because last time I explored it, I was not able to find it. However, I could be wrong. Wait, no, it did. But it's over this way. We gotta go up down to the, I don't know what direction wise this is right now, but this tower over here. Yes, this is the rookery here. But the thing is where's the window? How did we get the birds out of here? So we gotta go up, and I'm guessing that this is where you would leave the birds out, right here, these windows, and, or maybe out here, I don't know. But this looks like the rookery, because there is cages down there. And we're gonna go up the tower a little bit more. This is not the king's bedroom, at least I presume it's not. I'm presuming this is the maester's room. got, what do we got in here? I don't know what's in here, but I'm presuming this is the Maester's room. Reason being is it is above what looks to be the rookery, and you got like a little library, you know, such things like that. And I just think it just makes sense to be so. But we are going to head back down. Now, the cool thing is they have a ton of different, like, rooms for all the different servants, the miscellaneous guards here and there, all the, the kitchen staff, which would also be servants. They have rooms for a lot of the things. And also guest rooms, which is also a very important thing to have into your castles. All right, so I know that there is a way to get through here, right here. All right, so this is the king's bedroom. Now, the reason why I know this is because you got the balcony out here. It's so bold that obviously you would presume that this is the king's bedroom because, it overlooks his whole land. And so basically this is really nothing in here. There's really no really detail. You can imagine maybe there'd be some furniture up on this wall too, but Wester's Craft likes to minimize their interior detailing, well, at least some of the builders do, in order to make it less spammy, which is actually a good thing. And I'm trying to grasp that, because in my opinion, Conquest is hard to minimize interior for, because it's very, like, the textures are much more condensed, and they look much more, Conquest textures are just, much more condensed, and it makes it feel like, there's less space, and you gotta fill up, like, whatever open space there is, whereas the Wester's Craft pack feels like it's more full, like, the colors are much more, like, broad, and it really, like, I don't know, it has this horizontal effect, I guess, I don't know, in this room at least. I'm having a hard time explaining this because I don't want to tear down the pack, or both any of the packs. I don't want to, begin any confrontation at all. But I just think that Conquest, like, for me at least, when I'm building in that, I have to, like, build this crazy interior in order to make it look nice. But that's just me. I'm not sure if anyone else suffers from this sickness, or if it is a sickness, who knows. So now there's just lots of crazy things all around. Here we got this is actually really cool. I really like this design here. You got a couple armor stands here, and you head up and there's like a little balcony overlooking this little room in here. That is really cool. Just little things like that are just really, really interesting. You got a privy in there. They have privies everywhere, which is a very important thing of a castle because, actually no, in a real castle, I think that there was only, like, they would condense the privies because obviously they would be a really real pain to clean out. So they would have them, like, maybe for the, like, the upper class, they would have a few, readily available, but then for like the majority of the people they would this is cool, I didn't know this door came into here, but for the majority they would have to like walk a long way and all have to go to one privy that is way over there or something, I don't know. So here's a granary. Looks like this would be a place where they would store grain. Now the thing is like this whole thing would be full of grain. As you can see here, this is just full of grain. And then you head down here and you just take your barrels or your sacks of flour or your sacks, your open sacks, and you there'd be like some sort of mechanism where you would twist and then all the flour would start spilling out and it would fill up whatever you need, and you could use that for the day. But anyway, that is the granary storage for the castle there. And we head into here. Looks like this is a dung heap. This is the privies that are up above. This is really cool. They would just crap into here, and then this door would probably be closed most of the time, or maybe open to air it out. But one way or the other, this is a very, very stinky room, and I would hate to walk into this room at any time if I could smell it. So, yeah. So anyways, that is probably going to conclude our walk through Last Hearth, and there are many more walks to come, as there is so much on this server to see. It is absolutely incredible, and they have such a beautiful builds. The inspiration is there, the the building skills are there, the techniques are there, the ideas and designs are there. It's just incredible. For those of you that are interested, all you gotta do is just download their launcher, come on over and check it out, and have some fun, because that is the idea of this. Explore and just find things. I mean, obviously in this video, I have hardly scratched the surface on exploring even this build. And there is just so much to see. I mean, even look at this. Here is a gallows here, and this road heads down to who knows where, way out into the distance. And it's just a beautiful, beautiful fact that you can come through here and just explore and always find something new. For those of you that are interested in joining the Westeros Craft Server, all you need to do is apply on their website, and they'll take care of you from there. And so, anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I look forward to the next one. But again, I want to spread my wings, and I want to show more of the building community. As there is a lot of different people out there. You know, it's not all Conquest. There is also Westeros Craft, and there's Art of Craft as well, and other things and such like that. And just wanted to make that known in what little way that I can. So thank you guys for watching. I look forward to the next one. Till then, bye-bye.